Let's start by releasing the upper spine first. So you're gonna place your upper back against the wall. You wanna maintain the natural arch of your back, so don't push your back into the wall. Keep your sacrum touching the wall and pull your abdominal in and up towards your spine as you inhale. And then as you exhale, let your shoulders melt down into your spine while keeping that strength into your abdominal here. So you're gonna place your arms in this position. Now, some of you might find this quite difficult. Maybe you won't touch the wall. Maybe you'll be here, and that's fine. So as you inhale, you gaze forward and you stretch your arms above your head. And when you exhale, bend your elbows and squeeze your abs. Breathe and then exhale. Deep breath in. Exhale. One more time. Exhale. Last one. And then exhale. Lower your arms down. You're gonna grab a pair of dumbbell. You can use 0.5, you can use 1 kilo, it's up to you. And you're gonna start with your upper back is again pressing against the wall. You have the natural arch of your back and you're pulling your abs in and up. Your knees are slightly bent. Your feet are parallel, pointing, toes pointing forward. So you grab your dumbbells and you have your palms facing your thighs. And then as you inhale, with your spine staying against the wall, you breathe in and raise your arms up towards the ceiling. And then exhale, lower your arms down. Deep breath in. Exhale, arms down. One more time. Exhale. So again, you're going to respect the range of motion of your shoulder girdle for now. If you can't go all the way up, you go where you can. Exhale. Last one, deep breath in. And then exhale. Now this is your angel arms. Inhale. Exhale. Deep breath in. Exhale. Last one. And exhale down. So you go all the way up. Inhale. This time your palms are facing each other. You're going to nod your chin to your throat. Curl your upper back from the wall. Bend your spine. And peel yourself away from the wall, while your sacrum and your butt muscles still press against the wall. So your knees are bent and you release. You let go of your shoulders, you inhale, you roll your pelvis, you place your sacrum against the wall, the lower back, and your upper back, and raise your arms up towards the ceiling. Once again, chin to throat, curl. So you want your head to move ahead of your arms. Your tummy is in and up your spine. You bend your spine. Come forward. Exhale. Pull your navel in and up and move your sacrum against the wall, your lower back against the wall. And place your arms up. Touch. And then again, last one. And this time, once you arrive forward, you're just going to do circles with your arms. Exhale. And reverse. One more breath. And keep your arms really heavy. Curl your spine. And then head down, up against the wall and move yourself away from the wall. The lower back can be stiff because of hip stiffness and hamstring stiffness. So we're going to stretch the hips, the pelvis, and the hamstring. Place your right leg on a small table or bench, whatever you have that's accessible that can help you lift your leg and put it on something, but not too high. So the toes are pointing forward, the back foot is slightly turned out, and you're going to, as you lean forward, you're going to feel the back of the calf stretching, and that's a good thing. So you take your abdominal in and up, and you slightly lean forward until you feel a stretch into your pelvis, but you're also stretching deep inside your psoas muscle, lower belly. And then you stretch back. You do that a couple of times. Inhale. You exhale back. Last one. Exhale. And then you hold the stretch. So you try not to lean on this hip. So keep the leg under you, pull your abs in and up, and sink your right butt down as you pull your navel up. So you're maintaining the calf stretch, you're maintaining the glute stretch inside your spine, the lower back. One more breath, inhale. And then exhale and come back, stretch the leg. Now this time you're going to stretch the back of the hamstring, so the leg is straight, your toes are pointing up towards the ceiling. You're gonna inhale, lift your arms up or not, it's up to you. Exhale, bend forward, so you pull your navel back and you lift your abdominal in and up towards your spine. And then you inhale, come back up. And then again, you exhale. You inhale, come back up. Just remember, this is just to release stiffness. You're not right now increasing your flexibility. You're just releasing stiffness if before a walk or after a walk. Last one, exhale. Maybe you grab your toes, maybe not. And then one more stretch. You come back forward. You're going to bend the knee. And again, you're not leaning on that side. You're trying to keep your spine tall. Remember, alignment. So you flex all your toes on this side and you bend your knee. So you are releasing this hip. I have another version where my leg is a little higher. You can do this one if this one feels too easy for you. But this is, again, to release stiffness in your lumbar spine so you don't have to go too high. And it's a standing stretch that you can do before walks, after works, or as a cool down. Change side. Shake up your legs a little. Let's start with the left foot. So left foot flat, toes pointing forward, back of the leg stretching. You're stretching the calf. You can even put your hands here. You breathe in and you're slowly sinking into this left pelvis. Tummy up towards your spine and you're stretching the back calf at the same time. Navel to your spine, exhale. Deep breath in. Exhale, see there's no load into this knee at all because all the stretching is happening at your pelvis, glute muscles, lumbar spine. One more breath. Exhale and come back. So you inhale, you bend these knees. You're sinking this hip, really, and then exhale, come back. You're bending this hip, and then exhale, come back. Last one. Come back, and then you hold. No pressure in this knee. You're sinking this hip. You can place your hands on top of it. And then you stretch the left leg. You bring your arms up if you want to. Or you can keep your hands by your waistline for this side. Let's keep the hands by the waistline. You're not loading this hip away. You're pulling your abs up so your spine is coming up and over as you exhale forward. Then you inhale, lift your spine, grow tall, stack your spine up. And then you exhale. Deep breath in. Lift your spine, exhale. Last one, hold, stretch, pull your toes if you want to, or just keep your hands by the hip, pull the quad muscle up, support the back of the leg, which is where the tendons of the hamstrings are attached. One more breath. And then slowly relax your foot, turn out, lift your hip up, and allow this knee to fall down naturally, not by leaning and sitting in this hip. Hold your spine tall, navel up towards your spine, flex your toes, exhale and release. There should be a little bit of stretch here, and if you don't feel it, that's a good thing, but if you do feel it, allow it to stretch a little further, breathe in. Open your lower back, exhale. One more. And then come back center, shake up your legs. Let's do the standing roll down so your feet are parallel. You take a deep breath in, you use weights or not. So you lift your navel in and up your spine. Exhale, bend forward. Release your spine, release your spine, release your spine. And then come up. And again, arms rise up. Navel up towards your spine. Elongate your spine up. Exhale, bend forward. One last time, arms up. Exhale, you bend forward. And do small circles. Exhale. Change direction. Exhale. Release and roll your spine up. Move your hips, move your lower back. Stack your spine, shoulders on top of your pelvis. And exhale.
Spine strength is what you want to build over time. Yes, you can remove stiffness from your spine, but then it won't be sustainable if you don't build strength. Pilates is known to build spine strength because we have a lot of movement that involves moving your spine. Once you had the chance to watch a video, give me a like. It helps me continue to make those videos for you every week. Feel free to share it around with your friends and family, especially those who are looking to build strength in their body. So let's get started. You may use ankle weights as well. I'm a big fan of ankle weights if you do your mat work at home and you don't have access to strap in the studio. I'm also going to use small weights. If you have a pair of dumbbell at home, it can be just 1 kilo, that's enough to help you with your core. Start seated on your mat. Take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, switch your abs. Deep inhale, expand your ribcage in all directions. And exhale, switch your abs. One more breath, inhale. Exhale, squeeze your abs. On the next inhale, you're gonna roll yourself down on the mat and you're gonna place your hands at the back of your head. Interlace your fingers. Open your ribcage. You can bring your elbows close to your ears, not completely close. We're not doing sit-ups. We're just learning how to lift the thoracic spine and cervical vertebrae off the mat. So you inhale, expand your ribcage, pull your tummy in now. And then exhale, chin to throat, raise your shoulders and upper body off the mat. So the ribcage and the bottom of your shoulder blades are still on the mat. Deep breath in, exhale, two more counts, exhale, last breath, and exhale. This is just to warm up the thoracic and cervical vertebrae. And now we're going to warm up the pelvis and the lumbar spine. You inhale, curl your pelvis under, exhale, lower your pelvis down. Deep breath in, lift your pelvis under, exhale, a small arch of the back. You know, you press your lower back down, you will feel that your fingers, your forefingers are gonna come up, and if you're over arch, you will feel like your belly is trying to push your thumb away. So you want to keep them level to each other, thumb and fingers. So now that you find your neutral, take a deep inhale, lift your right knee up, lift your left knee up, extend your legs, lift your shoulders and head off the mat, and let's begin with the hug. Exhale, inhale, exhale, back to sitting, deep breath in through your nose, exhale up to sitting, grab your ankle weights for hold. So this mat work is a level 1-2. You are free to do just the basic 10 if this is where your body at, if you're new at Pilates, if you're new at the mat practice, or even just the 5. I'll mention to you when we get to just the 5 exercises or 10. Okay, so roll down on your back and bring your arms up towards the ceiling. You take a deep inhale, you pull your tummy in and up, and as you exhale, you're gonna squeeze your abdominal and support your lumbar spine. On the next inhale, we're gonna roll up. Melt the chin to the throat, exhale, roll all the way forward. Inhale, roll back, pull your tummy back, open your spine on the mat, shoulders and head. Inhale and exhale forward. Inhale, roll back and exhale, head down. It's ideal that you use an image, like I'm going to use a big wave, so to keep my spine elongated throughout the exercise. Inhale, melt the chin to your throat, roll up and over like a big wave coming forward at the short. Exhale. You keep your gaze down, you swell the weight back, put your tummy back, and exhale down. And again, deep inhale, the weight goes up and really tall, and exhale forward. Inhale, roll back, pull your tummy back, support your spine, and exhale down. Three more counts. Exhale. Last two. Stay with your image. Exhale. Inhale, roll back. Exhale, head down. Last breath. Exhale. Inhale, back. And head goes down. Lower your dumbbells down. And you're going to do the single leg stretch. As usual, I will leave a link below for those who need to do a modified single leg stretch. So bring your right knee towards your chest, open your elbows wide apart, and as you exhale, squeeze your abs and lower your leg close to your tummy. Extend your leg up towards the ceiling, arms by your side, you cross your legs as you twist your spine, breathe in, exhale. Your goal is to keep the bottom leg facing the ceiling, knees and toes. Two more times. Last breath. So five on each side. Reverse.
Furniture at home if you don't have a
because the furniture can overpress on the toes. But again, if you don't have, that's okay too. Lay down on your back. Bring your knee towards your chest. You can exhale. Inhale, extend the leg up and exhale. Arms by your side. Pull your tummy in and out before you move and exhale, hold the leg up. Breathe in. Two more. Last one. Reverse. Pull your abs in. Cross over, exhale. Two more counts. Last one, and bend your knees to your chest, come up to sitting, bend your ankle weight, bring your hands next to your pelvis. Sometimes I do this, sometimes I put my hands, pull your abs in and up, and come as close as you can with your heels. Grab your ankles. Now, you want to feel like you're massaging your spine. So open your ribcage, balance on your sit bones, lift your ribcage under your armpit, stay curl, exhale, deep breath in, two more counts. You don't want to throw your legs behind you. Pick your pelvis and legs in the same shape. Last one. Exhale, plant your feet down, hands next to your pelvis, pick your pelvis and move back. Now, if you are doing the basic five, you don't have to do the stomach series. Look for the link below and I'll show you how to do just the basic five. Now, if you are doing the basic 10, we'll do the first two exercises. Bring yourself down on the mat. So the goal is to strengthen your abdominals so your spine becomes strong. So therefore, as soon as you take your leg into your chest, you want to engage your abs to open your lower back. Place your right hand by your ankle, left hand by your knee. Deep breath in, open your elbows wide apart, take an exhale, squeeze your abs. And then you switch leg. You inhale for two, exhale for two. Exhale, one more time. Exhale for two, bring your knees in. You can lower your head down if you need a little break. And then we'll do double leg stretch. You may go legs up towards the ceiling, exhale. Or you can go legs forward. Obviously the second version is a little bit more intermittent, where you can feel your abs staying in and not your back arching. Last one, and exhale. Lower your head down, move your head to the right, move your head to the left. Come back center. So that's your two exercises for the basic 10 in the stomach series. Now I'll continue with the scissors. So you're gonna grab your calf, you're gonna pull your abs in, and you're gonna pulse, pulse, switch, pulse, pulse, switch. Inhale for two, exhale for two. Grabbing the calf is an option, grabbing the ankle is another option. Again, it depends on length of the hamstring and strength of the abdominal. Last set, two, one, two. I'm gonna take another break, lower my head down, take an exhale before I do the fourth exercise. Deep breath in, exhale. Bring yourself up and then bring your hands by your behind your head. Pull your abs in as you lower your legs down. Inhale. Exhale. Two more times. Last one. Exhale. Hold. Bend your knees over your chest. So obviously, the lower you go, the more advanced the exercise becomes. So it's all about being able to stay strong in your abs and not go in your lower. One last exercise, elbow to knee, which I call shoulder to knee, so it's coming from your thoracic twist as well as your movements. Deep breath in, exhale, bring your knees close to your face. You're going to twist your body to the left, and then come back and twist to the right. the last exercise is not part of the level two, but I like to add it, so I do make sure that every practice I do my stomach series. So it's an option. Spine stretch. So again, if you are a beginner, spine stretch will be your last exercise of the basic five. So if you are a beginner, this exercise will be the last exercise in your basic five. And if you feel like you're not yet ready to sit really tall without your hips collapsing under you, you can use a pair of blocks, yoga blocks, or put a cushion or bend your knees. So your arms will go in front of you as you inhale, and as you exhale, you're gonna roll your chin to your throat and come forward. And then you're gonna inhale, pull your abs in, and come right in the middle. Exhale. You're moving your spine against an imaginary wall by lifting your abs in and up. Exhale, you go forward. Inhale, you pull your tummy back, and you elongate yourself. If you're doing the advanced or maybe the classical, where your legs are straight, you exhale, bend your spine forward. So the principle stays the same. You're trying to roll your spine against an imaginary wall. And you go forward and back. Last set. And lower your arms. Down, take a little shoulders round. And then you're going to do open leg rockers. If you are a beginner, you're done, you can take a break. If you are basic 10, you can also take a break. And if you are working towards a level 2, this is where you continue to add this exercise in your routine. So tummy up towards your spine, you're going to extend your right leg forward, and then so the goal is to keep your spine in a capital C. It's not straight, you're not trying to stay like that. You're trying to pull your abs in and curl your spine. Deep breath in. You can look at the horizon in front of you, or you can lower your gaze down at the mat. It's up to you. When you lower your gaze down, it will keep your spine curled. Some more room to bring the two legs. And now to do the two legs again, so you have to find your connection to extend your legs with the same strength. Exhale, come back. If you've noticed, I've shifted my gaze to look down at the mat. So it keeps me from flattening my back and keeps me in the tummy. Last one, inhale. And exhale, bend your knees. Okay, you're going to lay down on your back. You're going to bring your arms by your side. You're going to do a few pelvic rocking. So these will turn into corkscrew. For this one, I'm just articulating my spine. And then twisting my spine. Stretch your legs for soft. So again, if you use block, that will be part of your basic 10. If you're using blocks, you're gonna prop yourself on top of two blocks or cushions or bend your knees. Arms by your side, open your chest, elongate your arms all the way up. Deep breath in, twist, exhale. So the more you bend your knees, the more you'll feel the rotation of your spine. If you don't have the hamstring length and your lower back is stiff. Deep breath in. Last one. And then come up center, put your arms down by your side. Placing your hands under your shoulders, your knees under your hips. contract. Inhale, look up. Exhale, contract. Inhale, look up. One more time. Now you kind of like flat back with your tummy up. You're going to extend one arm forward, one leg back for Superwoman, Superman. If again your body is not ready for swimming. So remember, we're trying to build the spine strength, especially the lower back. So if you're quite fragile there, I would say use these options for now. And it's also a great exercise. I like to add them, whether I do this one or not. I love using them. Next one. Okay, I'm going to do the normal swan now. Hands under your shoulders, you have your legs a little bit apart. You're going to inhale, breathe in to pick up your thoracic spine, then your lumbar spine, and then exhale, lower your body down. So it's not as like an up dog, it's more about using your spine to move up and down, rather than just straighten the arms. So you're still using your arms, but you're trying to do a reverse roll up, if you would call it that. Last one. And then exhale. And sit back. This exercise is great if you need to open your lumbar spine as you're doing your mat work. It's just a little small stretch to keep your lumbar spine open and stable. And then you roll up. We're going to do the side leg kick, part of the basic exercise. Why we do the side leg kicks? Because we want to support the pelvis. Because we want to build strength in the pelvis, which again supports the lower back. You're going to place your legs diagonal in the front. And you're going to hold your, bring your elbow in line with your ribs and pelvis. Place your left hand in front of you and pull your abdominal and lift your top leg up to hip height. You do a slight little turn out and you kick forward. Inhale and exhale and point. Inhale. Now alignment. You want your abs to stay in. You don't want to collapse to get your leg far. You just want to keep your abs long, forward and back. Long also here, so you're not crunching your lower back. You're trying to stay square in your pelvis. Exhale, squeeze your abs in. Exhale. Two more counts. Last breath, one, two, back, and back. Turn your leg out, you want to rotate your leg so we build the strength on the outer hip. Inhale, point, flex, exhale. Last one, reverse, flex, and then flex. You will notice that I keep looking ahead, so that I don't look down and strain my neck. So remember, you're building the strength, so all these little details matter. And then relax. You're going to turn onto your tummy. Forehead touch the mat. Take a deep breath in through your nose. Pick your legs, take an exhale, and then clap your legs in 2, 3, 4, 5, and exhale. 5. In 2, 3, 4, 5, and out 2, 3, 4, 5. Two more breaths. Last 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Lower your legs down. Hands under your shoulders. Push up. We'll go on the other side. So you're
elbow is in line with your ribs, your ribs in line with your pelvis. Pick your legs, you bring them diagonal with your eyes ahead. If you are not sure how to neck, just do it in front of a mirror. You will know if you're not pushing yourself too high and straining your neck. Place your hand in front of you, turn slightly out, and we go. 1, 2, breathe back. Back, inhale, 1, 2, exhale. Last one, and relax. All right, you'll come into a seated position. Seal will be the last exercise for all today. So what I did, I added a couple of new exercises in the level 2. There are a few more, but we'll do that for the next few weeks. Okay, so pull your knees towards your chest, bring your arms in front of you, grab your heels. Some space, so I'm trying to get up. Pull your abdominal in and out. And then clap your legs. 1, 2, and 3. You gaze down, you roll back. 1, 2, 3, exhale. Two more counts. Last 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Cross the leg and slowly come up.
Right, that was your strengthening your spine routine. So you can do that 3 times a week with your stretch until you feel strong to start adding on more exercises. Thank you so much for watching.